Alright, so we're not really gonna do an oldie today. We're gonna do a movie that I haven't seen, but I've heard so many good things about it, almost annoyingly. Too many good things about it. Knives Out. So this is directed by Rian Johnson and written by Rian Johnson. And it's got such a stacked cast. Ana de Armas, Daniel Craig, Chris Evans, you got Joseph Gordon-Levitt, Michael Shannon, Jamie Lee Curtis, Edward Norton. Oh my God, it just keeps going on and on and on. So yeah, super stacked cast. And it's pretty much just a murder mystery thriller, and I love murder mysteries. I heard it's really funny and just good all the way around. So yeah, not technically an oldie, but a few years old. 5 years old, that's old enough. And I really wanted to see Glass Onion on Netflix, so I gotta get this one out of the way. But let's just go ahead and get into it. I gotta get me that mug for sure. Hell no. Hell no to all those dolls. Hell no. Look at all the faces. All over the place. No. Every corner I turn with my peripherals, I'm gonna think someone's in the corner. Damn. Damn. What the fuck?
Alice, turn that off.
It's so ridiculous. Stop. Sounds like such a shit show. Sounds like a show you'd listen to on South Park.
Did anyone besides the family show face?
Fran, the housekeeper.
He was a nice guy, but he was so hairy.
Jacob.
And I'm dating Italian guys. You know
what I mean? What the fuck? Italian guys be hairy.
Jesus, Donna, you all right?
My son Jacob, he's 16.
This is odd.
Very politically active.
The boy is literally a Nazi.
He's an old.
What? Damn.
Hey, with the internet, it's amazing.
Oh my God, he's oblivious to his right-wing ideology.
Killed simultaneously, freed by and supported by them. It's a balance of.
What the fuck?
Pause, because I just. Who is that guy? Why are we doing all this again?
That's James freaking Bond.
So who the fuck is that?
This is Benoit Blanc.
Again, it's James fucking Bond.
I'm here at the behest of a client.
Who?
I cannot say, but let me assure you this.
He's got a southern drawl.
What did Holland say to you?
The Netflix guys are business affairs. He sent some over. It's hard numbers this time. And I just think this is a window that's not.
That's funny because the Netflix got the sequel.
I've kept you from building something of your own. That was yours. You're not going to be running the publishing house anymore. You're free of it.
Yikes. He fired him?
Dad, are you firing me? No, we'll talk details tomorrow.
Damn. Fired your ass.
She did hear Harlan in a screaming match with somebody that afternoon in his study.
And I don't. Screaming match?
Mm-hmm.
Guilty. He's guilty as fuck.
You tell her or I will.
You tell her or I will.
Bell's ringing.
Daniel Craig's nailing that southern drawl. Usually the English people can't do it, but he can. Oh!
That's none of your business.
You stay
up. Ooh, boy.
I've put all of it in this letter to her. Tomorrow she gets it.
Yikes. Everyone's got a motive.
Tell her.
The hell I am!
You tell her or I will.
Busted.
Alan's office has been wiring tuition directly to the school. As per your request. But Phyllis's office that handles your yearly allowance has been wiring tuition monies directly to you as well.
Ooh, stealing her daughter's tuition? Yikes. Everyone's got a motive.
Why don't we just take a little break in movies and open up? She's gone.
Guilty. Guilty.
Joni, have you seen Richard?
No, I was just in with
Kate. Okay, thanks.
No. Oh shit, he's hiding. He's looking for the letter. What? He bluffed?
I'm sorry, this is an open and shut case of suicide. And the method? Throat slit?
Yeah. Throat slit suicide? That ain't, no. What are all the motives? They're clearly lying.
How shall I put this delicately? You have a regurgitative reaction to mistruthing.
What? That's a weird way of saying she can't lie.
It's something I've had since I was a kid. It's a physical thing that I... Just the thought of lying.
Is Richard having an affair?
Damn, he's good. Oh, no.
Yes or no won't do.
No.
Oh, shit. Oh, oh, my oh, dear oh, my girl, God. I'm sorry. I assumed you were speaking figuratively. You tell her, or I will. Okay, but even if that were the case... You alright?
She's like a detective's best friend.
Oh my God.
He showed her everything. The hell?
Linda asked who hired me. Who hired you? I do not know.
What?
Oh, Picasso showed up at my apartment yesterday with a news clip and a throb of his death. 15 minutes later, Linda's awoken for the third and final time. Harlan. Who came down for a midnight snack.
Dad, go back to bed!
Which Walt tried to discourage. Based on this, the medical examiner determined the time of death to be between 12:15 and 2 a.m.
A lot of detail in this movie, I like it.
He's the one who cut his own throat, all right? I don't know why we keep going over this. Physical evidence can tell a clear story with a forked tongue.
What? Yeah, what?
I got it.
Why does the old man live in the attic? Too many steps.
Old.
Really love trauma, huh?
He's so goofy.
Until you can't tell the difference between a stage prop and a real knife.
He's just stabbing furniture. Oh.
You had a long day. You wanted the drugs?
You mean the good stuff? Why did I wait till my mid-age kind of to become a morphine?
Drugs are we doing here? Oh, morphine.
Yeah, stuff is the best.
Oh, no. She gave him morphine.
This is what I just give you 100 milligrams of?
Ooh.
You gave me 100 milligrams of the good stuff. Excuse me, but what is the good stuff's dosage supposed to be?
Not 100 milligrams.
3 milligrams.
No, that's much less.
Just a little bit.
Efficient method of murder. I need to write this down. So, if someone switched the meds on purpose, I'd be dead in 10 minutes. Like stone cold dead?
Yes, your full symptoms in 5. Sweats, disorientation, and then...
He's like, this is a good idea for a murder mystery.
If the victim didn't have the emergency Maxa stuff. Martin.
She doesn't have it.
Do you have that Maxa stuff?
Yes, I'm gonna find it.
Oh no.
I have it because it comes with the kids. It should be here. It has to be. It's like a...
Oh, look at him. He's okay with it. He feels bad for her.
Martin, listen to me.
Harlan, I need to call
stop
the ambulance.
Stop this!
Need
stop this!
To get here.
No time! You have to listen!
I'm calling the family!
What the fuck? He tripped her?
We have 6 minutes. Okay. We have got to get you out of this. Think of your mom.
My mom.
Just say that it was an accident. I mean, I guess they won't believe that, but... Pull out your phone and just record it.
Oh, hi, Joni.
Wow. So he accidentally died because she fucked up with the meds.
Firefly?
Wow, girl. Acting your ass off.
As soon as you can, and then say goodbye loudly.
Walt, I'm leaving.
Call attention to the time.
God, it's midnight already.
If you can.
Oh, smooth. His attention to detail is going to save her, but she's going to tell the truth.
What's it?
The after four, the car bill.
Oh, shit.
Park.
Uh-oh.
You've got to get up to the third floor without being seen. And the only way is to climb the side trellis and come in through the trick ball window.
You gotta be kidding.
So much. So many rules.
Walt is smoking outside.
I don't know.
He'll see you. Through the glazed window.
Dad, go back to bed.
I feel like he could tell.
You've gone from suspect number one to an impossibility. Leave the way you came. And don't be seen.
I like how he's covering up his own murder mystery as a murder mystery fiction writer. Oh, shit. Nana.
Ransom?
Ransom?
Are you back again already?
No, Nana.
You know I can't lie or puke.
I mean, don't lie. Tell fragments of the truth.
What? Very interesting. She didn't lie, technically.
Yeah, don't like him because you love him.
No, I don't like him. He's an asshole. Mm. But maybe an asshole is what we needed.
Oh, God, yeah. An asshole is what Germany needed in 1930.
Yikes. Oh, no. Wonder what they're talking about.
Take off your red cap, Richard, and look around you. The streets are literally flooded with nuts. There
That's
are
right.
millions of Mexicans coming.
Oh,
and don't make us a race.
They're still saying this.
I hate My hearing God. This. But it's true. America is for America.
Don't point at me.
Where's Mark?
Don't point at me.
Come on,
Richard.
Come on over, Mark.
Oh, no. She's going to get her involved in this. Great.
I mean, what I'm saying is they did it legally. She did it.
But they didn't.
You work hard and you'll earn your share from the ground up, just like Dad and like all the rest of us. And I'll bet you.
Yeah, I was going to say, you all inherited it.
Please if don't. You want to become an American, there are legal ways.
Oh, good. Asshole.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I'm very, very sorry.
Stop.
I hate
you. Sorry. Jesus.
God, my heart won't stop. I can't. It's just everything. No, thank you.
She's like, all right, I'll do it.
I'm so sad.
It's gonna open a clock.
She ditched that whole joint.
I'm gonna have to get you help.
Do as I say.
Oh shit, he did it himself.
I promise.
Is that how you want to kill yourself? Damn. So he did kill himself. Wow. That's fucked up. Couldn't they do an autopsy on the morphine? You know? On his body to check all that. Jeez, I can feel the tension, man. This is nerve-wracking. Ooh. Busted.
Now, that's a live feed there.
To avoid the security cameras, pull off the road after.
After the carved elephant. Oh, shit.
You gotta keep holding it down or else it'll eject. That thing eats tapes like popcorn.
Since you're gasping.
Luckily.
I can hang on to that.
Oh, she magnetized it. Damn, she's clever. She's sabotaging the case of her accidentally murdering the guy who writes murder mysteries. This is super clever. I like it. Oh, no. All the mud.
What?
Martin.
He's like, all right, go ahead, walk through it. She's just sabotaging them. Oh, these good babies.
This judge of character is a dog. Well, that to be true.
Anything suspicious or out of the ordinary, you'll know it when you see it.
Oh, it's the piece of wood she broke. God, she's so creepy. It's ransom.
Stop.
Not a dog person. Like he said, good judge of character.
Funny, Ransom, you skipped the funeral, but you're early for the will reading.
Very true.
Night.
What the hell were you doing in the bathroom all night?
Nothing. Oh, spotting Syrian refugees.
No, I was not.
Alt-right troll.
There was nothing.
I don't know what any of that means.
Means you're...
Oh, no.
In the bathroom.
Yeah, he was in the bathroom.
Joylessly masturbating to pictures of dead deer.
What?
You want to go? Bet, Skippy, let's go.
Oh, come on. I've been waiting for this my whole life.
I've been waiting for this my whole life.
Never easy.
Up your ass, Joni. You've had your teeth in this family's tit for a long time.
Up your ass? Very nice.
Matter of fact, eat shit. How's that?
You entitled prick.
Don't talk to your mom. Definitely eat shit.
God.
One iota of shit.
Not eating one iota of shit. Amazing. I love the dialogue in here.
Some of you may be surprised by the choice I've made here. No pleasure was taken in the exclusion, and its purpose was not to sow greater discord in the family, quite the opposite. Please.
Oh boy. Here we go.
Wow. Well, yeah, not too complex at all. This will be quick. I hereby direct that all my assets, both liquid and otherwise, I leave in their entirety to Marta Cabrera.
No way. What? He was obsessed with her. I guess he wasn't obsessed, just I guess she's the one that really deserves it the most.
No, Richard, we need to talk. We need to fight this thing. We're not going anywhere. I said get out. We are the Thrombies, goddammit. This is still our house.
Is it?
Likewise, the house at 2 Dearborn Drive and all belongings therein to Marta Cabrera.
This guy sucks at his job. Of course she gets it too.
Little bitch. Did you know about this? Were you in on this from the beginning? No, I just want to know. What were you doing? Were you boinking my father? Boinking?
What?
I had sex with my grandpa, you dirty angel baby.
Oh my god. Call her an anchor baby. Oh man, run. Run. Run from Jamie Lee Curtis the most. She's unhinged. Run him over. Oh no. Chris Evans is gonna be the hero.
I think this could be the best thing to happen to all of you.
That's funny.
Salami. What about the Slayer rule? I did just Google that.
The Slayer rule obviously doesn't apply here.
Well, what the hell is the
what
Slayer rule?
What the hell is the Slayer rule?
If someone is convicted of killing the person, they don't get their inheritance.
Not even convicted, even if they're held responsible for their death in civil court. Like OJ.
Ooh.
Yes. Like OJ.
Like OJ. Oh no, they're gonna pin it on her, and it's actually. It was her. This is fucking juicy, man.
I'm not gonna tell my family shit. You're not gonna go to jail. That detective's not gonna catch you. And you're not gonna give up the money. This is what.
What? What a twist. The douchebag became a hero?
What?
Yeah, I came, hey, how you doing?
Oh, God.
I haven't even looked at all this yet.
It must just be local lawyers and accountants who saw the news and want to get a job.
What? Blank letter? Weird.
Oh,
What? The family's gonna turn into fucking conniving bastards.
Want to avoid here? We can protect you from that happening, or if it happens.
So you're saying that even if it came to light, with the family's resources, you could help me fix it?
Yeah.
Because Harlan gave me all your resources. So that means with my resources, I'll be able to fix it.
Damn.
Better be sure that's what you want.
Yikes. Yeah, what's the blank letter? Oh, it's Nana. It's definitely Nana.
What's still pending from the autopsy?
Just a report of the blood work.
No. Yeah. On the morphine. You should probably get away from the scene.
You know what this means, right?
He's gonna see you.
You're totally in the clear.
Oh shit, he sees you. No, she's gonna look so guilty. Oh man.
Go, go, go. Are you flooring it?
I am literally flooring it.
That piece of shit ain't gonna outrun them. Busted. You're busted. The hell?
Listen, I don't know what you want. Whatever it is, we can work it out. But we have to figure it out right here, right now. And I'm leaving with that report. Hello?
Is that person even alive? What's going on here? Getting freaked out.
What are you saying?
You did this. Don't get away with this, sister.
What the fuck?
Part of you stays bright.
Are you shitting me? He's not the greatest detective in the world.
Story on the drive over. I don't want any more surprises.
Who is the anonymous person?
That you deserved to hear it from me.
Excuse me! You have not been good to her. You have all treated her like shit to steal back a fortune that you lost and she deserves. You're a pack of vultures at the feast. Knives out, beaks bloody.
He said it.
Not what I was expecting.
Is anybody else confused?
Not what I was expecting to hear at all.
Nana knows something.
What I did.
Yeah, but Fran wanted money. Ugly. She did not want the crime exposed.
Or did someone in the family had observed Marta doing something suspicious?
But they would have had no reason not to speak up.
Come on.
With the entire solution in mind.
It's like the Game of Thrones throne. What?
So sorry.
No way.
You might tell us all why you hired me.
He did? But why?
What were the overheard words by the Nazi child masturbating in the bathroom? Harlan told you everything.
You can't be serious.
Not a red dime or word of my work to a single one of them. You included. It's done. I'm warning you. That's some heavy duty.
Would take moments.
But it is essential that you are alone and undetected. You knew what...
Oh, he switched it.
Will you get your share back? You use the syringes in the kit to switch the liquids from the two medication vials.
Oh, no.
As a final precaution...
He took the antidote.
Hand me that vial of morphine.
So she didn't kill him.
You know, because you've done it 100 times. You gave him the correct medication because you are a good nurse.
Oh my god. I didn't think there was going to be a twist. I mean, not like this. This is a pretzel twist.
Listen, a few amateur theatrics.
Wow.
Fallen had listened to you and called the ambulance.
Oh, man. What a fucking twist.
Marta, when Great Nana spotted you climbing down the trellis, she said...
Branson, are you back again already?
Back again.
Branson, you're back.
Shit.
Of that. With your permission, I'd like to spin a little further. Much later, that
keep going.
Have to come back to the house to retrieve the incriminating tampered vials.
What?
However, this time the dogs were outside.
Yeah, the dogs. Good judge of character. Interesting. Damn.
Benoit Blanc. Benny, look, I hear what you're saying. You just...
He's loving it.
Or so you think.
Oh, no.
But she knew you were up to no good. So her mind begins to turn.
Oh, God.
A blood tox report will prove her guilt. He goes to the will reading in high spirits, ready to see the family tear itself apart, secure in the knowledge it will be all undone when the tox report comes to light. And then...
Daniel Craig is killing it.
Don't come near me! I'm warning you!
More morphine. Ah.
You did this.
She didn't say, you did this. She wasn't talking about me. She said,
you did this.
Ah, Hugh. Damn, man. All the little details.
Because you're an asshole.
Because you're an asshole, yes. Captain America's asshole. Fucking James Bond is handing you your ass.
Play your game. She saved Fran's life.
Fran's alive?
Trooper Wagner, if you could keep Mr. Drysdale in custody while Lieutenant Elliot, Miss Cabrera, and myself, we go to the hospital and take Fran's statement.
All right, up, come on.
Oh, man.
You think I'm not going to fight to protect my home? Our birthright? Our ancestral family home?
Oh.
that is who he... Yeah. Holland, he bought this place in the 80s from a Pakistani real estate...
Really?
Shut up!
Really?
With that Kentucky Fried Foghorn Leghorn drawl!
I love this shit.
Nothing. What, attempted murder? I get arson for the building and a few other charges with a good lawyer, which I have. I'll be out in no time. And then you'll see just how much hell I can wreak on your life, you vicious little bitch.
Oh! Oh! Ew, she puked on his fucking face!
And you just confessed to her murder.
Busted. And you got puke on your face.
In for a penny.
Oh shit! Oh shit, Captain America! Get him, Bond! Oh shit! What? Oh, it's a prop! Oh my god, the foreshadowing in this shit, man! Oh my god.
Shit.
would have been great if she puked in his face again. Dude, this movie's fucking nuts. This movie is fucking clever. Oh, no way. Oh my god. Everything's full circle now. Oh shit. Dude, you're fucked. Everyone's fucked.
What did you know I had something to do with Harlan's death?
Oh, from the first moment you set foot in front of me.
He spotted the blood. What? He saw that little drop?
You're a good person.
This family.
For real. This fucking family.
I should help them, right?
Fuck no! Did he get punched in the eye? I'd help out Meg and maybe, I don't know, probably just Meg. My house, my rules, my coffee. Hell yes, dude. That was a crazy ride. That was fucking written very well, Rian Johnson. So why couldn't you make a Star Wars movie? Wow, wow, wow. I did not expect it to go this wild. This was a crazy ride. You know, at first I was kind of thinking Daniel Craig is like in over his head and it's just not, I don't know, it's not as entertaining. And I thought it was just going to be Anna just kind of covering up her mistakes and it was going to be goofy. But I didn't, as soon as he mentioned that there was someone who hired him and we don't know who it was, I was thinking it was Nana. And then the whole time I thought it was Nana. And just the littlest bit of details that you think are just, you know, funny, or they were just to slip by or to fill the space and to fill the silence. But it, no, it all meant everything. It all meant something. And all tied up at the end. And it was brilliant. I thought it was like a crazy well-written movie. Like, I am shocked. And the whole time you thought that she accidentally killed him, and she didn't, and then he actually killed himself, and Chris Evans was behind the whole thing. That was fucking nuts. Now I really want to watch Glass Onion. The entire cast did great. Anna stole it. Daniel Craig, amazing. Even Chris Evans, he was freaking charismatic in here. I thought it was funny too. There was a lot of funny bits in here. Just every now and then, Michael Shannon talking about I ain't eating an ounce of shit or whatever when he was telling everybody to eat shit. First, Chris Evans' character was actually super interesting. You know, at first it was like, oh, he's the asshole, he's the spoiled rotten brat. And then he thinks, or then it turns out like, oh, maybe he's just, you know, he's going to help her out. He doesn't care. He did like his grandpa and he wants to stick it to his family. No, he's behind this whole thing the whole time. It's so crazy. And I was waiting for the whole big reveal with Daniel Craig, and boy, did he do it. But I honestly wasn't expecting it to end that way. And what I mean by Daniel Craig kind of being not the greatest detective is he was blindly... Not blindly, because he said that he knew that she was involved with the death since he saw the drop of blood on her shoe, but he was like dancing in the car, or he's singing in the car and shit, so he's obviously letting her have her own space to fuck about when he didn't even know that she was innocent yet. So yeah, every character had its place. Everyone did what they were supposed to do. It was a juicy, juicy, detailed movie. Amazing. Amazing. Not a second could be taken out of this movie and have it work. That's how detailed it is. Every second counts. Every word counted. Every detail counted. And That's just good movie making, honestly. That's like a 10 out of 10. It was brilliant, and I cannot wait to watch the sequel. But anyways, guys, that was my reaction to Knives Out, and I'll see you guys in the next one.